Welcome back. The North Dakota State volleyball program went through some changes in the offseason with its head coach leaving. Former Bison player and assistant Jennifer Lopez has taken over as interim head coach, and NDSU is off to a quick start in Summit League play with wins over South Dakota State and South Dakota this past weekend. Here's Brian Shawn with J-Lo.
All right, thanks so much, Kelly. Here with Jennifer Lopez, the interim head volleyball coach here at North Dakota State University. And Jennifer, a Bison through and through, grew up just down the road, Dilworth Glenn and Felton High School, played for her mother, Jean, played here at NDSU, and now the head volleyball coach. Hard to believe where you're at. You grew up down here, you played for the Rebels, had a really successful high school career. Is it surreal for you to be in this position in your first year already?
You know, it definitely is, and I would say, you know, just being able to be so close to home and being a part of this community, it's been good, a little bit surreal, but definitely somewhere I feel like I'm a good fit for and a good, good position to be in right now.
Absolutely, and your sister obviously played here, had a very successful career in high school. Your mom coaching you, I know she had a big influence on you. How much has she helped? Because she's been in a head coaching position a lot of years, has been through a lot of those peaks and valleys that you go through at this level all the time.
You know, it's kind of funny because I talk with my mom quite a bit. I talk with my sister quite a bit, who's also in coaching, and being able to have somebody that understands what you're going through, is able to kind of bounce some ideas off of, and knows kind of what to say and what not to say, is really been helpful. And her experience and what she's been able to do, even at the high school level, is beyond anything that I hope I can achieve at some point in my career as a coach. But it's been very helpful as far as listening to her and hearing her advice.
Whether you want to hear it or not sometimes, right?
Right.
Well, Jennifer, for you, this all happened pretty quick. With Kerry Thompson moving on, you were with the program, you came in. What were some of the things you had to do right away to acclimate yourself from going as an assistant coach to being a head coach?
You know, very comfortable to begin with as far as knowing what our program's about and continuing to move it forward. It's now just kind of the decision making, and a lot of those decisions fall on me now that I'm able to then kind of put into place and create some things. And so that's kind of been the biggest, just a little bit more on my plate. But for the most part, it's very comfortable and very easy to kind of make some decisions.
You've been home for a couple of weekends. You've also been on the road for a couple of weekends. Have some big wins. You won a couple of tournaments. You've had some really good success with some kids stepping into roles they haven't been through before. I'm guessing you're pleased with that through the non-conference.
You know, very much so, and that's kind of what preseason is all about. It's getting your team comfortable, and especially with our six freshmen that we have, and working them into some of the lineups and them getting comfortable with what they're doing. They've shown a lot of progress, and even our returners too, and the level that they're starting to play at and the expectation they're setting for themselves is pretty high. So we've been able to do quite a few good things throughout our preseason here going into conference.
When you look at your team, what did you want to be the foundation, or what did you want this team to have your stamp on it, so to speak? What do you want to be known for, and how have you tried to instill that here through the first 4 weeks of the non-conference?
Honestly, it's our culture and what we're doing, and in creating a culture that's exciting for us to be able to play at a high level and to get people excited about what we're doing here at NDSU. And I think so far we've been able to do that, and it's definitely something that we're going to continue to improve upon. But overall, like, I like where we're at. I like what we're doing, and our kids are continuing to push themselves. They're setting the tone for what it is we're trying to do, and very happy overall with that.
Summit League, we know the schedule gets tough. There's going to be tough road trips, there's going to be tough home games. You know what's coming, you've been through these battles. What's it like playing Summit League conference volleyball, and how does the mindset change once you get into the conference?
You know, it definitely changes as you go into it. I mean, now it's teams that you know about. It's teams, kids that you've been playing against for 3-4 years, and now kind of seeing them and being able to kind of play in a different light is kind of exciting. I think going into conference, I think we'll do a pretty decent job as far as matchups wise. So I like where we're at. I like being able to go against South Dakota, Oral Roberts, Denver, and being able to hold our own, as I think we'll do a really good job at with this year.
What have you learned most now as a head coach taking over? You're still pretty young. You're, you know, one of the younger coaches in the league. It's not an easy position to be. I'm sure you're still learning every day too on how to motivate some kids and how to keep things going on a day-to-day basis.
Honestly, In working with the kids, it's doing what you know and creating the culture and being able to just go with it every single day and continue to push and try to get better. And I expect that from my kids, but I also got to expect that from myself too and our staff. And I think that's something that we've really like grasped the concept of, is getting better every single day. And overall, very happy with that.
We wish you the best of luck. Thank you so much for spending a few moments with us, and we'll see you down the road.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
All right, Jennifer Lopez, the interim head volleyball coach here at NDSU. Kelly, back to you.
All right, thanks, Brian. North Dakota State will host Denver and Oral Roberts this weekend. The Bison are a perfect 5-0 at home this season. When we come back, we take it over to the Ralph for coach talk with UND Hockey's Brad Berry. And a little bit later, a look at our live programming schedule for the week. Stay right here.